This video will cover three things: my needle story, tips and stretches to getting your needle, and proving myths. People saying you need this certain stretch in order to have your needle, but you really don't.
This is my needle story. I started dancing about 3 years ago. Here's my scorpion after 10 months of stretching once a week at dance class. Now imagine my leg half of that height at 4 months. Fast forward to this year, I went through what I call needle week. This took place in February. I started out my first day attempting my needle, but failed. My second day, failed again. Third day, feeling sore, tired, but I still kept trying. I still failed. On the fourth day, I came close. Fifth day, I came even closer. And then sixth day, this happened. So I guess I wanted to share my story because I wanted to let you know that you can't do it all today, but you can do it. You just need to have patience and persistence in the practice needed to reach your goal. Now, I'm going to help you get your needle. Before attempting your needle, you must stretch out your legs, back, and shoulders. If you need more detail on how to do these shoulder stretches, go check out my scorpion tutorial video. I will link the video in the description below. This is a more advanced seal stretch. I put my hands on the wall and straightened my arms and pushed back. For this next stretch, I would aim to walk your hands down and up 3 times. And once you've done it 3 times, go into your bridge, maintaining a gap between your hands and the wall. Push your chest into the wall, go on releve, and think of pushing up and forward. Another stretch is to go into your bridge and walk your hands and feet as close together as you can, but make sure your legs aren't extremely bent. Go on your elbows to get a deeper stretch and push in the direction of the arrow. Then go back into your bridge and push your bottom to the floor, keeping your chest up. Lastly, try straightening your legs and holding it there for 10 to 15 seconds. And after, take the leg you're going to put in the air for a needle and push it back as far as you can. Lastly, we're going to stretch our legs. I've gone into depth on how to do these stretches in my beginner's stretching routine, so I'll leave a link below in case you wanted to check it out. Although you don't need to have your oversplit to do a needle, I have found that being able to do my oversplit made the process of doing my needle a lot easier. So like I said in my other videos, even if you barely have your splits, I still want you to attempt the oversplit because it will help you in the long run. I have heard many people say that you need to be able to grab your ankle in order to do the needle, but that is completely untrue. I can barely do this stretch and I am even on the verge of doing my needle oversplit. I don't think this is a formal exercise for stretching your needle, but it worked really well for me. The goal is to straighten your leg and bring it forward as much as you can. Also, keep in mind that you don't have to do all these stretches daily. Just pick one or two from each category if you have time. There are 4 steps to your needle. 1. Spot. So stare at something that catches your eye and never take your eyes off of it. 2. Pull your leg up into a form of a scorpion. Examine carefully how I pull into my scorpion. 3. Begin to walk your hands down, and as you are doing that, resist falling back and instead think of falling forward. Lastly, get your hands as low as you can, and remember, the lower down your hands are on your leg, the easier. Just pull, and I would think of pulling forward and upward. This is Claudia, and she direct messaged me her progress. First off, her leg extension is already incredibly high and gorgeous, but you can still notice the improvement in the two pictures. I'm so glad that you find my tips helpful, and thank you for supporting my videos, Claudia. My second feature goes to Ashley. I'm really happy to see your results using my tips and that you find my videos motivating. It was great messaging you, and thank you for all your sweet words. Keep up the amazing work.
If this video helped you guys get your needle, feel free to share your results below so everyone can see. And don't ever hesitate to direct message me on Instagram if you would like a feature or if you just want to talk about flexibility in life. And if you want to be featured, here's the criteria. You have to send me a picture of your flexibility progress, explain how my videos have helped you, and just say, I want to be featured. But if you don't, if you want to just talk to me about flexibility, YouTube, life, don't hesitate, because I like talking to you guys because it's actually a lot of fun. And a lot of people actually have been direct messaging me, so I'm like really happy because it's like a lot of fun to talk to you guys. Here's a quick video schedule. I post a new video every Saturday. One Saturday I'll post flexibility, the next I would post like whatever I feel like, then flexibility, then what I feel like. So flexibility, random, flexibility, random. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video next Saturday. Bye, stay fierce.